Hello everyone, this is topic 10 of the human anatomy lectures. This is lecture 1 of the 3 lectures that I would deliver on endocrine system. The endocrine system, just like the nervous system, regulates the body's activities by coordinating the functions of the other organ systems in the body. The difference between nervous and endocrine system is that the nervous system produces very quick response. It's a short-term response and the responses are very specific. The endocrine system, on the other hand, it takes longer time and the responses are long-term. While these are not as specific, they are more generalized. The endocrine system regulates the activity of other organs by using special messengers, which are hormones. So the hormones are released into the surrounding medium because endocrine glands are ductless. So the hormones go into the interstitial fluid, and from then on it goes to blood. So then the hormone causes a response in the target organ or the tissue. The following are the functions of endocrine system. First, reproduction. All of you know testosterone, the male sex hormone, and estrogen, the female sex hormone. Reproduction is not possible without these hormones. Growth and development. We have a special growth hormone that helps in the elongation of bones and in building up muscle mass. Mobilization of body defenses. There's a hormone called thymosin. There's another one called thymopoietin. These hormones help the T cells, which are the most specialized soldiers of our body, to become adults and to become effective soldiers. Maintenance of homeostasis. Most of the thyroid hormones, they play a very important role in homeostasis. Regulation of metabolism. I think all of you know how insulin helps in metabolism of glucose in the body. There are 9 major endocrine organs in the body. These are hypothalamus, the pituitary gland, which is also known as hypophysis. This is the master endocrine gland. The third one is thyroid gland, parathyroid gland, thymus, the suprarenal or adrenal glands, pineal gland, pancreas, and the reproductive glands, which are the gonads, that means the testes in males and the ovaries in females. Some other organs with secondary endocrine functions are the heart, which also secretes 2 hormones, the kidney that secretes erythropoietin and calcitrol, fat or adipose cells, which secrete leptin and resistin, the digestive tract, which secretes numerous hormones. So these organs, they have their own primary functions, which is different from hormone secretion. So hormone secretion is their secondary function. This figure shows the major and the minor endocrine glands along with the hormones that are secreted by them. So once you are done with this lecture, I would recommend that you hide the labels with your hands and then try to answer, you know, what is what. So the endocrine cells, they produce the hormones, and the hormone is secreted either directly into blood or into the interstitial fluid, and that eventually takes it to blood. So blood has the job of taking the hormones to its target sites, and hormones are highly specific. Although blood is taking it, it just wouldn't randomly bind to some other organ. Chemically, hormones can be classified into 4 types. The first type is an amino acid derivative. Amino acids are building blocks of proteins. The examples of amino acid derivative hormones are all the thyroid hormones, which are derivatives of the amino acid tyrosine, the adrenal medulla hormones such as epinephrine, that means adrenaline, and norepinephrine or noradrenaline are also derivatives of tyrosine. The pineal gland hormone melatonin is derived from the amino acid tryptophan. The second type of hormones is peptide hormones. The word peptide means a linear chain of amino acids. So these hormones are chains of amino acids. These are some of the simplest proteins. Example is all hormones from the pituitary gland are peptide hormones. The third type of hormones are steroid hormones. All steroids are derived from cholesterol. So you see, not all cholesterol is bad. You do need cholesterol in the body to make steroids. Examples, reproductive hormones such as testosterone, estrogen, as well as hormones from the adrenal cortex. The fourth type of hormones are known as eicosanoids. These hormones are derived from a special fatty acid of the cell membrane, and that fatty acid is known as arachidonic acid. Examples are prostaglandin, leukotrienes, and thromboxane. Hormones can cause so many effects. They can change the permeability or the electrical status of the plasma membrane. They can cause the synthesis of proteins such as enzymes. They can increase or decrease the rate at which enzymes are made. They can start mitosis. They can also cause the cells to start secreting. Hormones are very specific and they affect only their specific target cells or target organs. And these target cells must have specific receptors which are made of proteins for the hormones. So the hormones would go and bind to their specific receptors on the target cell. There are two mechanisms by which hormones act. The first one is for steroid hormones only, and they act by direct gene activation. The second one is for all non-steroidal hormones, and this is by second messenger system. Let's understand the direct gene activation mechanism by using the figure on the next slide. In this figure, the steroid hormone is shown with a small structure in the left side of the figure. It's golden colored. The cytoplasm is also yellowish golden, while the nucleus of the cell is shown in purple. So the steroid hormone has the ability to diffuse through the plasma membrane of the target cell, and then it enters the nucleus. Within the nucleus, there's a receptor protein for the hormone, and the hormone can bind with it. Once it binds with the receptor, it forms a hormone receptor complex. And now the hormone receptor complex can bind to specific binding sites on the DNA of the cell. Once it binds to the DNA, that means the genetic material, then it can make a new type of RNA. And the RNA is like a photocopy of the DNA, and then the RNA moves out of the nucleus into the cytoplasm, and it can help in the synthesis of a new protein. We will also understand the second messenger system of the non-steroidal hormones using the figure on the next slide. The non-steroidal hormone, which is shown with the blue triangle, this does not diffuse inside the cell. Instead, it binds to the receptor protein on the plasma membrane of the target cell, and this binding produces the complex, which is the hormone receptor complex, and this starts off a series of chemical reaction and activates a particular enzyme. The enzyme is shown in pink color here. Now the enzyme catalyzes a reaction that leads to the production of a second messenger molecule known as CAMP or cyclic AMP. And this CAMP is a very important molecule which has effect on cellular functions such as glycogen breakdown. The level of a hormone in blood is usually maintained by a self-regulating system, which is known as a negative feedback. So in the negative feedback, a stimulus, let us consider the example of high glucose levels in the blood, it triggers more output, and the output would be release of insulin hormone in the blood. So once the appropriate product level has been reached or it has been maintained, so in this case, the blood sugar has been brought down to an optimal level, then the production of the hormone stops. That means the insulin hormone release stops. There are three types of stimuli or triggers of endocrine glands. The first one is hormonal stimuli. Second is humoral. Humoral means body fluids, for example, blood or the interstitial fluid. And the third one is neural stimuli. That means nervous stimulus. The first one is the most common type of stimulus. It is the hormonal stimulus. Endocrine glands are usually activated by the hormones coming from other endocrine glands. For example, hormones secreted by the anterior pituitary, they go to various target organs such as the thyroid gland, and then they stimulate the thyroid gland to produce other hormones such as the thyroxine or the triiodothyronine. This figure shows how hormonal stimulus comes from the hypothalamus, which stimulates the anterior pituitary to secrete some hormones, and then hormones coming from the anterior pituitary in turn go and stimulate the thyroid gland or the adrenal cortex or the testes to secrete their own hormones. The second stimulus is humoral. Humoral means body fluids such as blood, bile, interstitial fluid. So when the level of certain ions increase or decrease in the body fluids, it stimulates the secretion of some hormones. Example is, when the level of calcium in the blood increases or decreases, it stimulates the secretion of either parathyroid hormone from the parathyroid gland or calcitonin hormone from the thyroid gland. Another example would be how insulin is secreted from the pancreas in response to changing blood glucose levels. This figure shows humoral stimulus coming from the increasing or decreasing levels of calcium in blood. The third stimulus is neural or nervous. This is when nerve impulses control hormone secretion, and most of these hormone secretions are controlled by the sympathetic nervous system. An example is the secretion of adrenaline and noradrenaline by the adrenal medulla. This figure shows neural stimulus. This is again a recap of the major endocrine organs in the body.